Okay, hello, people. So I'm going to be porting a weapon from ARMA 2 to ARMA 3. I won't be showing how to set up the P drive and all that jazz because effort. If this folder or this partition, P drive. That's where you work out of when you're modding shit, specifically for ARMA 3, probably other shit too, but. All right, so we have here on my desktop the A2 samples, which are downloaded from Google it, ARMA 2 sample files, which will give you a couple downloads on the, I guess, a BI wiki, which has sample data, unbinarized data from all the from ARMA 2. So here's weapons. Here's wheeled vehicles, HMV and all that shit. This is all the map stuff. File. You need objects for map, but us doing weapon. So weapon CA. It's looking just vanilla weapons. I think this is ARMA 2. So we got this. All this shit. I don't want any of these. This will be, I believe, Operation Arrowhead. Or updated everything else too. One Operation Arrowhead was put out. So we'll be doing the scar. Never got that somewhere else, so we'll be taking specifically this scar, so we'll look at it real quick. So this is the scar that I'm going to be touching, since it already has iron sights and I don't wanna copy paste and fucking Frankenstein that shit. So with this, you have different level LODs for distance. So this would be in third person, the closest LOD. View pilot. The pilot would be first person itself. So when you're looking at the gun, it's first person view. This is what you see. This would be third person. You and other close players and shit. Two, three, and it just gets farther and farther. I don't know the exact distances. Maybe 2, 3, 4, 500 meters, but I doubt it. Something like that. You also have the shadows, the geometry. And the memory points, which determine functionality basically with the weapon. So, like for example, this is the eye slot. This is where your eye goes. So you just look at the scope. Have other things like this will be for the bullets that come out of your gun. Nabo, which I'm not gonna pronounce that. Some fucking Czech shit. This will be the front of the gun, etc., etc. Trigger axis where it rotates back. And that's it. So I'm gonna close that. So you basically just copy that from here into your P drive, wherever you want to build the add-on. Specifically, you'll do it in the root. So all the so let's say DSR UI. This is a PBO. So I'm not gonna actually use this, but so this will be the PBO. This will be what the game uses in your. So let's look at. For Taurus, this is basically how it's going to be laid out once, I guess, released. So you have your key folder, and then you have your add-ons folder with the PBOs, and they're signed, meaning they can be used for multiplayer, basically, with a signature check. So you normally, the right way to do it really is to do it out of the root. I mean, 90% of the people do it. If they don't, they're annoying. Cup. So we have DSR weapons, which is the PBO that we have that controls all of, or holds all of the data for these weapons. It's fucking obvious, you know? So we have assault rifle. We have the scar here. And this is the scar. I just renamed it from iron sights, just regular. Nothing in the data folder yet, because I literally just copy pasted this a second before I recorded. So we get into the model. We're looking at this shit. Okay, we're gonna start messing with it. So I guess I'll start with the view pilot. You're gonna want to remove Zalesh, which is muzzle flash in, I guess, Czech. So we delete that, and we go and delete the proxy for the muzzle flash object. Because the muzzle, because everything is an object. So we have deleted the muzzle flash for view pilot, which is first person view. So now if I just somehow pack this and make it work and leave everything else the same, we go in game. In first person, I wouldn't have a muzzle flash, but in third person, I would. So everything has to be uniform with all of the LODs. Everything has to be identical. So all of these extra LODs, why is there not, whatever. So everything you do has to be mirrored in each LOD. So we'll start with the view pilot again. So that's basically done. That's all you have to do, at least for this specific model. You get the bolt for the gun, the, yeah, that's for the, I guess, reloading. So utilize that. Do that later though. In the magazine, the trigger, and the muzzle flash again, which you delete. So we'll just, I guess, save that for now. So you can also view this in 3D with the non-existent textures at the moment, but you can view this in 3D with this button. Or view viewers bulldozer start, which brings up the 3D viewer with textures and stuff like that. So we have this, there's nothing on it, but we see what it's gonna look like. So it's basically a scar. Nice. So the iron sights, got these iron sights are terrible. Whatever. It sucks for whoever's gonna use that shit. So you also see, yeah, all this shit. You can also view the lower level details as well. So this is what it'll look like from, I don't know, 1,000 meters away. I lost it. No, come back. Oh, no, come back. Hello? There we go. No? Yeah, there we go. So more and more detail as you get closer to the unit or the weapon, whatever. Then this would be what it looks like to everyone else, and then this would be what it looks like to you. Just a little more detail, you know. There's memory points. Click that already. So we're done with that for now. So now we go to the other LODs and do the same with the muzzle flash that we deleted earlier. So delete that. You delete the proxy for the muzzle flash, and you defeat the selection for the muzzle flash. Number two, same thing. Delete the actual proxy. Delete the muzzle flash. Delete, delete, and delete. Delete, delete, and delete. Five, that doesn't even have one because it's a fucking shit game. So save it again. So now this could technically just go in now because that's the main thing, but we're going to be re-adding the muzzle flash again and renaming it from Zaslech to actually muzzle flash because I'm not Czech. So we'll do that now. So we're in the view pilot. I always start with the view pilot first because it does not fucking matter, but I do. So you go to create, and then you can create points, spheres, like I guess objects, but we're gonna go proxy. Proxies, I didn't explain this earlier. Proxies are essentially, it's a proxy. You add another object to this object. So I could proxy, I'll just do a really shit example. Back up, up. No, oh, fine, I'll do it like this. So we're proxying an AK into this fucking scar. And that should be, I'm probably retarded and it's not gonna work, but it should work. So we go look and in the scar. Where you at? Yeah, there's an AK there. So the AK is proxied into this model. That is essentially what is happening. So we'll be using that for a muzzle flash. So the muzzle flash will be on the model. We'll do that right now. Is this centered? Yeah. It's fucking, some of these guns aren't centered in the very middle, which is really fucking triggering. So we'll create a proxy for with different muzzle flashes. I usually just use the, is this it? Yeah, the MK20. I mean, you can customize the muzzle flashes, use different ones for different things. I just use the MK20 for most of these assault rifles. It's just simpler, so I don't have to go fucking searching for new ones. Doesn't have to be exact where it starts. Because you have the little flash, and then, well, the little, I guess, explosion, and then you have the flash. The flash will always be about a couple inches out, a couple, a lot of centimeters out, whatever. Fucking, Well, go up. So this should be in the very center. Muzzle flash, in my opinion, does not need to be perfect, because it does not need to be perfect. The suppressor needs to be a little more perfect, just because it you can't have it a little off, it'll look dumb. Muzzle flash is less big, less important. You still need to have it, because it'll look dumb if you don't, and your gun won't have muzzle flash. So you just basically just copy pasting all these to each lot. I might do top 5 as well, didn't have it originally, but I'll do that. So you just control C, like you copy something. So now you see in the bottom, the proxies, they're all there, which is very cool. Now we go back to view pilot. I'll just save that. Save as much as you can. I mean, I learned this from Terrain Builder. Fucking shit crashes every like 20, 30 minutes if I'm not careful. So I learned to save often, which is good. So now we select, just select one of these to get it in the selection, then select the proxy. Let me make this a little wider. No, oh, okay, yeah, shit's fucking dumb. God, I had this problem earlier. No. Yes. Yeah, that's good enough. Yeah, I'm sick. Alright, so now we're selected using this proxy, or we could select using Bolt Magazine. So this is how you create named selections, basically. I think that's what it's called. I don't know, what fuck terminology. So we create a new, and we create name this Muzzle Flash, and click Enter. So now, this proxy has, I believe, it's called Name Selection, so now we click Bolt. It shows that area, that, and Muzzle Flash, it selects our proxy. So we don't need to have proxy this huge path, because this just passed to a proxy. The proxy is now linked to this named selection, which we would come to and use later in the model config, which controls animations and functionality of a model, like moving parts, essentially. So it's really big for vehicles and stuff. Weapons don't need as much of a model config. Most buildings don't even need very much of a model config, unless it has a door. Doors need... Okay, so when you open a door in ARMA, it activates, I guess, basically the model config, and that door, that piece of the model animates. I'll go through the whole process simply, quickly, later. So we'll save that, and I would do that for all of the sections. Remember, everything's got to be mirrored. Everything has to be identical. So we select muzzle flash, new muzzle flash. No, flash. Number two, proxy, new muzzle flash. Proxy, new muzzle flash, and done. Number three. Alright, and muzzle flashes are done. So now this will basically show up, show the end result, essentially. As you can see, we have a muzzle flash now. The gun is firing. Yes, there we go. So you see a little bit of explosion comes out, boom. And this is when it's firing only. Because, again, in the model config, we'll also spin this muzzle flash. So, you know how some model, yeah. So it'll spin this muzzle flash, I think, either 90 degrees, 60 degrees, or whatever I fucking set it to. So it'll spin the muzzle flash around, so it seems random enough when you're firing your gun. So, that's that. So we may as well get a texture on this fucker, which we will do now. So, when porting, it's very simple. Doesn't want to close. So you select the entire model. I usually, again, use the pilot, because why not? So how does the texture define? What makes this that white thing? Or when we get textures, the textured part, like tan, because this is normally tan. I might retexture that, but for this, I guess, demonstration, I will make it just tan. So we look in tools. We have mass, texture, and material naming. So this, everything selected, these are all the textures and RV mats for the material linked to each selection on this. So let's select this magazine. If you want to individually see what this is textured by, you click E, and it brings up all the face properties for all the faces. It's basically gibberish to most people. But basically, these are all the points and everything. So, what you want to be looking at, this is only really for... Yeah, you don't really look at this much, especially if you're just porting a weapon, not really making a weapon from scratch, model and all. So yeah, the texture. This is the texture that it's path to. CA weapons E, SCAR data, SCAR out TGA, and then the material, the RV mat, which has other data. The main actual texture that you see in game would be actually on the model, and then in the RV mat will contain like the shadow, I believe, LOD, the SMDI, like glossiness, other material things. Like, so this is just a texture. This defines how it's gonna look, like how the texture will look, kind of like a material, like, you know, metal sheen or like dirt and etc. It's a bad example, but you get the idea. So anyway, we go to this. We can actually, let's go to my P drive again. I have CA hidden. If I unhide this, which I will show you, I do this really, this is really good for when you're porting things. When something is in the root of the P drive simulates the game engine. So pretend P is ARMA 3. So A3, everything in ARMA 3 is passed from A3 to ARF. ARF is a PBO in ARMA, then to all the data. So all I do is create another folder path inside for CA, and it breaks the whole thing. So that's why that's white. So if I take CA and move that into my P drive, this is all the ARMA 2 data, which you also have to extract when you're porting because you need textures and whatnot. So I have this now basically in the game. This is now a PBO loaded in the game per se. We load up Bulldozer. And we'll see what this looks like, because everything is pathed, as you saw, CA, weapons E, SCAR, and then the textures and stuff. So now we go, and it's got its textures. This is what it will look like if I don't tweak anything while pathing everything. So I will be copying all the textures that this is using into DSR weapons and the SCAR folder that you saw in the beginning. And this will be the SCAR. I will most likely retexture this tan to be black, because black's more universal. Tan's kind of like, oh, desert, but yeah. So we'll be doing that here now. And it's really good practice to hide it, because then you won't create dependencies when you're packing with PBO project, because it'll automatically create a dependency, and unless if you're looking, you won't really realize. So it's always good to hide it, make sure everything is functioning. Basically, when you're creating something and it either relies on some or on another PBO or add-on or something, remove that from the root P or wherever it's pathed to work in, so you actually see what is wrong or what you missed to make your add-on without being dependent on another add-on, basically. Good example. So we have the SCAR. This is my P. Yeah. So we'll go to A3 folder, CA. Scroll down to the weapons PBO from ARMA 2. Wield E, weapons E. Scroll down a bit more to the SCAR. So this has all the data. These are all binarized, so you can't... There's a reason why you use the sample files, because when you open a binarized B3, it does not tend to work. So we got a data. And these are all the SCAR things. This is all the data for the SCAR. So let's say short.cl. This is, I believe that's like a red dot. Yeah, I think that's the red dot. Let's see what the hell this is. Surefire, what is that? AU suppressor? I don't know, whatever. So SCAR.hco. This is basically the texture. I believe this is the one that we'll use. SCAR heavy, SCAR L. Yeah, we'll probably use this one, because it's a light SCAR, not a heavy SCAR. So now we will select the entire model again to see what textures we actually are using instead of just eyeing it. Yeah, SCAR L. So we'll see CA data, penetration, metal plate, CA weapons E, SCAR data, SCAR accessory, XCO, light. So we'll start just copying these. So we'll take scar axe, take everything, because these are all linked in the RV mat together. No HQ, SM, oh, SMDI, copy that. Data, paste that. So now we also have scar light, which would be this, and all of these. So I'll just take the whole fucking thing. If we have any extras, I might delete it. If not, I just kind of leave it in, because I'm fucking retarded and lazy. So that's it. Then we have CA. This is actually a common file with ARMA 3. Let me just... Yeah. Some files, like this one, for example, you see the paths only a little different. They switch. Well, updated from ARMA 2 to ARMA 3, it's a very similar path, so you don't have to actually... take this and put it in your files. That should work. And it might be a different path, whatever. But you get the idea. There's a lot of common paths between ARMA 3 and ARMA 2. You'll see one here soon in one of the RV mats. So let's just actually repath all of these now. So CA weapons data scar 8. So we type DSR weapons A rifle scar data. And we take the RV mat, rename. We take the scar accessory TGA. I'm just doing it as PAAs because lazy. So you repath. TGAs are just higher. They're a step before PAAs, so they're higher resolution, I believe. But yeah, lazy. And it looks fine in game. Well, that texture we looked at is acceptable enough. And I'll probably be retexturing it a bit, so it'll be fine. We're good, boys. So scar LTGO PAA and scar metal. And done. So that should all be repathed. We'll save again. Okay, now we go into the RV mats, which are basically the material files for, like, no HQ. That's, I think that's, like, the detail. No, I forget. We have the AS, pretty sure this is shadows. This will determine shadows on the object. I think lighter is less shadow, darker is more. Don't quote me on that. I'm fucking retarded. Etc. TI, more shit. Most of this is pretty important. Without it, it won't work. Our shit's fucked. So if we get to that TR, we just looked at. So we'll close these, and we'll get the path. I'm just going to copy the path from here, because I'm fucking lazy. Tools, mass texture model, so weapons. So we have the texture, weapon CA data. So we have now DSR weapons, assault rifle, SCAR, data, default TI, CA. So now this path is correct. DSR weapons, assault rifle, SCAR, data, TI. You can put a slash before, but doesn't make a fucking difference. Kind of does, but it kind of doesn't. At least from what I've seen. Maybe it's completely fucked, so I'll have to go back and do all my things again later. And then, so, this is a file that we didn't get, because this is in a different folder. This, I believe, is also a shared file between ARMA 2 and ARMA 3, but I just copy and paste mine because I don't give a shit. So, we'll go paste. Most of this is just texture repathing, weapon porting, very simple. Creating a config to make the weapon function differently usually is probably, in my opinion, the harder part. But I usually just copy an ARMA 2 config, ARMA 3 config, and adjust it because it's quicker. You can do it either way. I mean, I do it the lazier way, but you can do it the not lazier way and be a better human being. So we go to data, we go to assault rifle, let's see, AK-74, I think that has both, yeah. I just copy both of them because this is metal rough, some are metal detail, etc. So data, paste that, and we're good for that now. Copy that. Another scar. CA A3, another same same path texture basically. You just turn C8 to A3. Alright, we're done with this. I got the next one, Scarlet Light. This is most ugly, specifically for this gun. Paste that. Paste that. Yep, again. Paste that. Yeah, it's getting hot. Turn my fan off so there's no fucking background noise, because Cotton Hollow Land was fucking bitching about that, but it's getting toasty in here now. Paste that. CA A3. Plastic, that should be the same. Okay, that's done. And last one. Scar, paste. Scar again, paste. And I'm just kind of blind pasting. If we're missing anything, we'll get notified by PBO Project, because it's micro tools are kind of mandatory, especially if you're dumb like me and you just willingly do shit and there's like incorrect paths and stuff. Very useful. I'll at the very end, I'll show you. I'll just put a link actually in the description, because I'm not gonna fucking look for that shit. Paste again. And A3. But regardless, suffice to say, they're basically ARMA 3 tools on steroids. Fucking super savage error checking, and basically, if something's wrong, it will tell you something's wrong. That will make it not function. So we're done with the 3 RV mats for this scar. Now we can basically just start it and see what it looks like. Our CA partition, oh no, not partition, our CA folder with all of this shit is hidden. So now when we look at this, this is all us now. This is our textures in our folder. So now this gun is ours, I guess. Not ours, but it's not dependent on CA. It's not going to function. This will function now, or this will look correct when you pack it, because this is all pathed into your PBO, your folder, which will be turned into a PBO for the game. Now we make it functional. Before that, we would add another proxy for the, what's that thing called? Scopes. Can there? Yeah, I don't think I'll put a I could put a bibod right here. I don't think I will though for this. Yeah, that might look kind of funky, because your hand's supposed to be on this grip, and the bipod will be kind of cutting your hand off, and jabbing your hand. Is that closing? It's closing. Alright, bud. What's this other one? Oh, untitled. Get rid of that. We don't need this. Close you. So now we save again. Back into the pilot. Yep, we're here. So now we create a new proxy, which you'll have to find these paths. I'll hover over this for a second just so you can see them. A3 data F proxies is where all of these proxies are located for various things. So weapon slots, top. That is the top of the gun. Basically attachments. We also have weapon slots muzzle, which is the suppressor, basically. Then there's also I think underbarrel, which will be bipods and stuff like that. And then you have, I think, side is what it's called, for flashlights and whatnot for the side of the gun, or whatever else you might make. Mostly probably just flashlights if you're just porting something like this. So create proxy weapon slots top. This is done, so now this is down here. I will raise that up. This might take a couple packs and checks just to make sure it's actually so the gun, the attachment's not floating. I usually sink it down a bit, just a hair. That's usually okay. A little more even. Yeah, it's good. Right above the magazine's a good place. It'll look fairly balanced on the rifle, maybe even a little farther back. So no, that's sideways. Let's see. Backwards, just a hair. That's good. So we'll save that. We'll make sure we have it checked. So top, we have this proxy selected. Control C for copy, and just paste it along to all the other LODs, so other people farther and farther away see the attachment basically sitting on your gun. Save that. And we have one last proxy to do, which would be the front. suppressor, or most likely suppressor, or I don't know. You could even take this piece off and turn that into like a flash hider below the barrel. Oh, is this separate? I can't fucking tell. No, it's not. So, yeah. Most likely a suppressor then. This is most likely a 5.56, the light, SCAR light. Yeah, SCAR heavy is 7.62, so this will be a 5.56. The actual proxy for the attachment doesn't matter, but in the config for the add-on, when we do that after in a couple minutes, that'll be 5.56 ammo and whatnot. So we take slot and muzzle. Okay. Slide that forward. Stick it kind of right there. I think that looks good. It'll the very beginning of the suppressor will cover that, and then go forward. Sometimes like, a little farther back even. And one, we'll bring it up. About as high as it. Yeah, that should be fine. I'll probably go back later, make sure that's perfect. So we go back, proxy echo. Let's remove that proxy. Don't want that shit there. So muzzle flash, top, trigger, muzzle. So we copy this, paste that, paste that, paste that, paste that, paste that, and we're done. Save. Oh, there we go. All right. What's this look like exactly? Yeah, for this also, you see how these attachment, the iron sights are very high off the gun. We'll need to animate these and have them go down when you have an attachment, so they're not just kind of in the fucking way. Like some, I've seen some people do that. I wanted that for sure. On my first gun, I made sure I did that, and it took a while to realize how the model config was because I'm also kind of dumb. So. Yeah, that's good. You'll want to do as much little function out like that as possible, just to make the gun feel better when people are using it. So we'll save this. That will be in the memory. That's going to be in the memory side. We'll do this after I get the config. Yeah. Okay. So we'll warp drive. So now this is DSR weapons, assault rifle, SCAR. So now this is technically done. I'm gonna be doing more soon in a minute or two, but this is basically good to go. So now we'll go back. Take the M4. No. Does the scar have bar burst? I can't fucking remember. Anyway, so now we want to make this function in game or show up in game or this or make it actually work. So we go to A3. We're just gonna do quick and copy in ARMA 3, weapon config and change it up a bit. So look at rifles. TRG 20. How does a TRG fire? I can't remember. Mark 20's no, Mark 20 shit. SPAR 16 could actually work too. I'm gonna do a SPAR 16. So we'll go back to A3. This is the weapons, vanilla weapons. Beta, boot camp, EPA, don't know what that is, EXP, cart, mark, etc. EXP is Apex. So we go rifles. SPAR 1, which is a SPAR 16. You have the config. So this is the SPAR 16 config. This makes the gun sound, makes it use ammo, animate. You select the animations, hand animation that's holding the gun, just holding. Reload action is a gesture. Like a wait, you wave hi to someone. That's reloading an ARMA. Great. Weapon slots, etc. And then here are the specific weapons designated, but they're linked items. Which we won't do. So we'll just straight copy paste that. So now this is our gun. We made this. This is us. We did this all ourselves, etc. We're not thieves. Khaki, SPAR 16. We're gonna remove everything that is Apex dependent. So basically, config patch is tells the game what this is going to be. So we'll name this like everything else in DSR weapons. DSR underscore weapons underscore scar. Basically the weapon name. Something simple to identify what this is going to be when you open it in the game. I think the config browser or etc. Yeah. So then let's bring this back. We'll be changing some of these sound effects. I think this far was actually a bad gun to choose, but whatever. So now this will determine what gun will actually be. So again, same DSR path. You'll be doing yours however you do yours. Black, yeah. We'll make that tan because I do want a black version as well. I might just have two. No, we'll just have it plain for now. I'll do that later on. Fucking laptop's heating up. Turn the fan off. I might turn that on. You'll get background noise, but fuck you. Alright, so A rifle spar 1 base. This is the base rifle. This is not what you see in game. The very bottom, this is what you see in game. I'm not going to be using hidden selections for this gun either. Hidden selections basically a quick TLDR. Camo 1 and Camo 2, we go into the model. So for example, this selection here would be called Camo 1. So now, this is Camo 1. So let's select Camo 1 and see it in 3D real quick. Hidden selections are really useful for retexturing things. It's basically how you retexture anything that already exists, so you don't actually edit the model. So now, see, this is Camo 1. So we could realistically go, I don't even think anything else in the gun is, yeah. So we'll just go and take this, Camo 1, so now we save this, and now this is Camo 1. So now we can go back to the config, Camo 1, hidden selection, where's hidden selection textures? Oh, I guess they didn't even have it. So we'll have a fucking section called hidden. No, I'm retarded. Hidden selection. Oh, it's ready. Whatever, that already exists, but no. Equals. And we'll path the texture in here. Like Mike's path. Shitlord. Mark 16 CO.PAA. So now this CO texture, which is the texture, now this is going to be the new texture for the gun on Camo 1. So this, I deselected it. Whoops, retard. So now this will be this will be different texture. This could be black, this could be pink, purple, whatever. So this is really good to have, especially if you're making a weapon pack that people you think may retexture it, or if you're retexturing it. It's a very good way to retexture things in the config, super super quick and simple. So now we're gonna, I'll leave that actually. I don't care. So we're just gonna get rid of that. Hidden selections. We're not gonna have that. I'll make that all work later. So save that. Go here. DSR. Base. Author Crazy Dyke. Display name, doesn't matter. Scar L556mm. Description short 5.56mm assault rifle. I was gonna put battle rifle, but it doesn't matter. So the picture overview. I believe this is doesn't matter at the moment. Model, we'll path this to us. DSR weapons. A rifle. No, not enter. Oh, fat fingers. Scar. Should just be Mark 16. Save that. Make sure I'm not retarded. Yes, Mark 16. Hand animations. We'll find this will be a lot of trial and error, basically, for the reload and hand animations. The spar animation might actually fit this very well, because this is a similar similar design, but the scar anim hand animation's like on the magazine right here, which is fucking stupid when we have a grip. Right, magazines 5.56. This will be fine. This is all good. This is the reason I chose it, because I didn't want copy paste. Bullet, if your sounds, weapons, library description. I just make all of these the same, because for what we're using these for, you don't really need that. People aren't really gonna, aren't really supposed to, I guess, look through all of them, because zombie survival, blah blah blah. Library description, yes. Muzzle, SMD, khaki. Yeah, it's fine. Cow slot, all good. Actually, we're going to. We don't have a pointer yet. We're just gonna break that real quick. Compatible items basically lets you designate a specific item that can be used. Anything not in the list won't work. So, quick example. UK74 did these, I think, like yesterday. Did I scroll past it? I probably fucking scrolled past it. Yeah, I scrolled past it. Oh no. Right here. This AK will only be taking the PSL, PSL3, and Cobras that I made, I think, 2 days ago. Quick example. So if you put nothing, this, it should take any attachment. That works. Yeah. Exactly. Single, yeah, these are all fine. Fire modes. And now we'll get rid of everything but that first one. So now we go up and we inherit the SR Ace Rifle SCAR base to the actual SCAR we're using. And it's not going to be base, it's just going to be DSR A Rifle SCAR. Again, we just do this. This is mainly, you could do it another way, which is having everything in one class instead of a base weapon. But I do want to make new different textured versions, so hidden selection textures, this is where it was, fucking hiding. So you have, this is the black version, there's also the tan version, this is where you define that. But we're not going to have that for now. Picture display name, general macro, copy, paste, paste. Display name, we'll go up again, because I made a cool name. SCAR L556mm. Same naming scheme as the ARMA 3 shit. You got the gun name, then the caliber, and then millimeter. Because uniformity is the key. SCAR L. Might do a SCAR H2 later. That could be cool. So yeah, that's it. This just have a SPAR 16. Let me go to ARMA 2. So we'll go back to the ARMA 2 shit. We will go to Weapons E. We go to Data, which holds lots of very fucking random data. Go to the icons for the weapons. Magazines. SCAR H. Gotta find mine. Yeah, this should be it. Yep. So this is our gun. This is what we use because it's quick and easy. This is a dirty way to do it as well. There's a better way. See the name of this, Black FXX. There's a correct way to do the picture, but I'm just gonna do this for because it's quicker. Like that. Close U, P drive U, DSR weapons, assault rifle, SCAR, data. So now we'll create new UI. This is UI, that's where this goes. New folder sounds, if we're using custom sounds. I do all these no matter what. And anim for hand animation, reload animation, most likely hand animation. I'm not no fucking animator. So I won't be able to make a reload animation. So UI SCAR. Let's just go up because laziness model. SCAR data. UI. No, not enter. Fucking fat fingers. And we'll copy the name there. So yeah, this should be done. I'm probably fucking missing shit, but. Let's. It's simple. It'll have the SCAR sound, not SCAR. It'll have the spar sounds, which I can change later on. I do that afterwards. So now this config should be done. Yeah, we'll need to move this because this would make it dependent on fucking Apex stuff. Actually, I think that's... yeah. What's that? Yeah. Exit that. Now this is done. This is good. But it won't function correctly, as in nothing here will work, basically. This muzzle flash will be there forever. Won't be able to reload your magazine correctly. This, is this animated? It probably can be. Alright, close this. Now we go to the model config. So, oh. I believe my M110 is where I copy from. So the model config, essentially. M110, the skeleton bones. These are all the selections. Selection 1, selection 2, etc. Scroll through, this is where we're doing the muzzle flash. This is reloading stuff, bolt. When you're firing and whatnot. Trigger, the bolt again. Magazine reloading. And then hiding the optic. This is what we'll use specifically for ours. So we have this copied. Yes, we do. Start rifle scar, paste that in. So now we'll close the M110 because we don't want to fuck with that. Open the model config for this. Take M110, replace M16. Huh. Whatever, it's on M16, but. So replace all 5, so now we have M16 weapon. M16 base weapon. Weapon base, and the skeleton name is M16 weapon. Go all the way down, and MK16. I might actually fix that, because I think it won't matter, but it'll matter to me. MK16, replace all. Yep, and now we're good. So specifically the sights, this is what I want to animate the most at the moment. This has to go backwards, this has to go forward. So we'll basically just make a new selection. I'll do number 1 as well. So new. No, we're not going to do new yet. Foresight. Yes. I want to type new foresight. Okay, so now this is the foresight selection. Foresight, 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 like foreskin. And we have backsight. Which would be this fucking thing. That should be good. Yeah, that should be fine. Backsight. Save, and now we go to the memory, which I mentioned in the beginning, which will be where things are animated. A lot of stuff's already here because ARMA 2. This is just direct port. You'll have to do these yourself if you're making a whole model from scratch, which is kind of cancer. But even then, you can just copy-paste. It's like 80% copy-pasting, really. So now we go to backsight optic, axis, backsight, axis. So it'll be rotating on an axis. So for example, see on the trigger here? There's 2. That's creating an axis along the z-axis, I think. So now it'll rotate on this axis going like this, or like that, depending on what you have put in the model config. So we go here, and all we do is just create a new point. So insert for a point, click insert for a point. This should be on, no, it's not fucking even, actually. Bam. Okay, that's close enough. Slide it forward a wee bit, slide it up a wee bit, slide it up a lot actually. Slide it forward some more, slide it down a hair so it's in the center of that rotation. I think we'll be bending it forward, so that should be 90 degrees. My M110, does it fold backwards or forwards? I can't fucking remember. Whatever. It'll probably be backwards, but that's fine. So we'll just copy this, deselect it, paste it, click Z to move it sideways, and we'll move it sideways to create the axis. So now it'll rotate 90 degrees forward, 90 degrees backwards. We select these two and create another name selection. Foresight. New foresight axis. So now this is the axis for the foresight. See, axis, foresight, just to name it all. So it bends 90 degrees, negative 90. Is that a fucking... I can't remember. I believe the gun's facing backwards in Object Builder, so that should be correct. 90 degrees that way, 90 degrees... Yeah, we should be good. That should be correct. So now we will do the same for... Oh god, I need to change the color of this thing, dude. Oh, cannot see shit. So I'll just line this up perfectly, right in the center. Create a point. Where's my point? Here's my point. There's my point down there. So, x-axis backwards. Y-axis up. Looks like... yeah, I can't see shit. This is gonna be fucking... It's gonna look really bad, I can tell. That should be fine. Copy it again, paste it again, sideways, move it over. We'll go to get backsight axis. New backsight axis. Now this is our backsight axis. That should be fine with the way I have my model config. You'll most likely have to find one. I could paste this down below, but this is the one that we use for like all of our guns, and that's kind of effort. This is the license under ARMA public license, share alike. Oh, so I could actually release it. Yeah, I forgot. Fucking forgot about that. We're open. I guess it's gonna be open source at the end. So yeah, I'll do that. I'll paste it at the bottom for fucking plebs. I mean, it's not. It's just a quick and dirty one, anyway. And this would be for rotating your iron sights left, right, up, down. But we don't need to do that. That's mostly for like AKs and stuff to animate the sight going up. But I didn't do that. I'm lazy. So that should be good. So function, this should function all correctly. And we'll save that and close. Alright, I don't think I fucked anything up. So now we'll just open PBO project, which is basically packs of PBO. These are apparel, no. These are weapons, yes. Sign PBO, full build, MP. This doesn't matter for me, but this will matter for you, making yours. Like I said, I'm not going to be going through the whole process to get everything set up because I'm not making a guide on how to do that. I'm making a guide on how to port a shit weapon and do a mediocre job. Just a whole fucking process. From Armor 2 sample to Armor 3 in-game. Delete that. That's that PBR I just randomly packed in earlier. So, yep. That'll pack for... I think actually like 200 seconds or so. Oh yeah, I already got an error because I fucked something up. So we'll check that. Fuck this guy. Yep, scar. RV mat. Yep, I fucked something up. Scar data. Default TI missing files. So we'll go check that and see what I messed up. Assault rifle scar. I missed something. Default TI CA. I had scar CA. TI CA. P. Do I have that another file? I believe I do an AK? No. So we'll go back to P drive, A3. No, not A3, A2. So we'll go back to our hidden folder. Weapon Z data default. Are you here, baby? Yes, default TICA. What's this? Oh, just literally a default kind of thing. So we'll copy you and put you where you belong in my fucking mouth. Scar data. I'm not gay. Default TI. So now that's good. That's all in the correct area. Yeah. See, now I know I forget something when you're just fucking blindly copy pasting. Which is why People Project again is so fucking good. Micro tools. Well, this is packing. I'll Google that. Micro tools. Right here. First link. Micro tools. Files. I think this is fucking DevFlow 6. It's all. No, we're good. So you'll want to get all these tools, as well as the ARMA 3 tools, the ARMA 3 samples, lots of things. There's already videos on how to set all this up. But micro tools are fucking awesome. So close that. You see, it's got paid tools, which are even more awesomer, more functionality, more updated, which I don't have them, but I strongly suggest doing that. So that's all packing the DSR web and shit. And I'm just packing into my own little PBO here. So I can fucking just load it in and see if it works before I push it to get updated onto the actual files. Alright. I think I've been talking, so I was supposed to have music playing, but I didn't do that. Oh, whatever. I have a fucking lovely voice. Show vehicles on the map. If you can't fucking script shit, don't make a server bud. German community, smart map. Yeah. Done yet? No. Keegan's gay. Yeah, takes a bit. Bigger your files are. Sometimes, depending on the size, it'll be quick. But lots of stuff here for a 2-pack. Takes about 200 seconds or so. Last night it did. I was doing DSR apparel. Making backpacks. That took about 30 seconds. Alright. Oh yeah, attached to, I saw that. Nice, cool bud. Alright, whatever. Data. Yeah, got some more client copying pre-binarized files. I'm basically done, so we will go into CM11s, wait for that, we'll open ARMA 3, we'll check it out in game, see what's up, might be good the first try, but I forgot something already, yeah, muzzle flash, sear weapons, assault rifle, AK-74, model config, this is something else, you'll be forgetting lots of things left and right, like this selected fire animation. Muzzle flash, that's why we named this muzzle flash in the very beginning. So, selection fire animation. So basically, when you're firing, it shows the muzzle flash. When you're not firing, it hides the muzzle flash. But right now, we'll have a muzzle flash no matter what, because I forgot about it. Config. So now, when I repack again, it'll be functioning incorrect. But we'll just load it in a way for the sake of it. My game's actually gonna take fucking ages to load. I may as well just repack now. It's OBS. That's fucking trippy, dude. Yeah, so also we'll go in later and change some of these things. I'll have to make it so it's not Apex things, so there's no dependency. Because I believe right now there is a dependency because of that. Yeah. I think the gestures are fine. Gestures are just loaded through config. I believe everyone has the file is loaded because you see the fucking content, but you'll get an error when trying to interact with said content. Yeah. No, whatever. So, config convert. I'm just checking my other PPO to see if I fucked up. Well, what the Apex shit. Where did I unpack that? Oh, yeah. Yeah, if you want to read something, it can't be a bin. It has to be a CPP. Bin is binarized, so you're not a fucking computer. You can't read that shit, bud. DSR. Oh, no. We're good. Doesn't actually force a dependency, which is very nice. Actually, I know why. Because I'm not looking at the wrong right fucking thing. Yeah, this one I have to do. Assault rifle, no back. Assault rifle, score, config. Yeah. Force dependency for the scar because of this and our picture. No, just that, I believe. Yeah, just that. That's fine. I'll fix that later. Because then the gun technically now requires Apex. Or at least when you use it, it should give you an Apex error. It's all right, just let's so unsticky that. Let that fucking thread die. Is done yet? Oh. Yeah, so that's basically it for the most part. Retexturing is a little bit different. I might just go start on that now while this is packing, so you can just watch me fucking idle. So weapons, Zor rifle, SCAR data, SCAR ACC. I believe this is like the front grip and stuff. Oh, yes. I had that already there. So DXT1, save. Save this as a PNG. This is part of the ARMA 3 tools. Text viewer 2. So just download. Fucking had them open a second ago. But yeah. Download that. We'll have this. I'll probably fuck with it and then have someone who actually knows what he's doing do it correctly. Or make it good. Just for the fucking hell of it. Save. So open those in a bit. It's done. Just about. Add-ons, paste. Delete the door. And we're good. See him from ARMA 3. Not the workshop. Yep. And play. And now we'll load in for about 10 minutes because my computer is fucking dog shit. And we will see what this looks like. I think it should function correctly. The iron sights might fucking flip backwards, but that should be it. Keegan, you're there, bud?
Yeah, I'm trying to save the Germans.
Oh, well, you're low as fuck. You have fun saving the Germans, bud.
Battle of Kursk, so that's all that matters, bud.
Oh.
Gotta turn the tide, man. Turn the tide again.
What's that?
Alright, so we have plenty of fuel. I can drop the production of fuel down a bit. How are my tanks doing? Are they there yet? They are there.
He had a gun, dude.
Alright, we're gonna... spearheading to Moscow. We're gonna try to take Moscow. Now they're taking another army is taking Lenin. See, they've been sieging.
Yeah. You're fucking low though, dude.
What?
Are you like away from your mic or something?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I'm mid recording this fucking I guess web importing thing. I just finished the scar. Sort of finished the scar.
Shit. I can't let this fucking lose this battle here. Delete orders. We'll defend Crimea from back here.
Alright.
Defend Crimea from back there, yeah. Construction, build a trench there as well.
This, yeah, okay, you'll be able to see that shit. My computer, shit, fuck, dude, takes forever to load in.
Oh, the Italian defense is like, not being affected, so I'm gonna pull these two armor divisions off and send, or no, I'll pull two of these guys off and I'll send them to the Eastern Front.
People are starting to complain about server lag because there's so many, like, sleeping mats and shit around.
Yeah.
All they have to do is just fucking delete the objects in the database, right? And that should fucking solve that problem.
Finland's gonna lose a winter war. V2.
Oh yeah, I forgot to fix that.
The Soviets repositioned all their armor to follow mine. God damn it. Rome is being bombed now.
Alright,
we're
in.
Great.
Almost. What side? Yep. Fucking, I suck. So, let's get, pull this dude. Let's get this loadout. Weapons, sort by fucking mod,
really no point in
bottom, AK, M4, oh, Scar L, there's my Scar, baby, yeah, animation, oh, that actually kind of fits, so I don't know, I had to lower the model, yeah, oh, fuck, I suck, why you no work, oh, no. We'll use nothing for now. Suppressor should be correct. Yep. Might just make it a little bit. Oh, yeah. That's fine for there. Save. Oh, fucking ammo. Okay. And play.
Looking pretty shit.
I wonder how long I've been doing this for. Only like 30 minutes. Oh, there's no sounds. Yeah, I'll do that too. Yeah, that fits good though. coming back in, I have to fuck with the, yeah, that's good.
Third Moscow conference, major allies of World War II, took place on October 18th at Moscow's Kremlin Palace. Diplomats, blah blah blah. A declaration on Italy, a declaration on Austria, and a declaration on atrocities.
I wonder why this other piece doesn't. I could add that to the selection, actually.
Oh, the Soviets are attacking me again. Good. I'm gonna get some gains out of this. Life.
Whatever. Okay, so we have. Okay, my sorry, my fish. Here. All right. We fucked up somewhere. P drive, weapons, assault rifle, SCAR, model CFG. Foresight and foresight axis, Mark 16. Oh, it probably does work, but I just forgot to make it work in everything else. Backside force it. Yeah, I'm fucking dumb. Forgot about that piece, baby. Okay. Backside and foresight. Let's go to lot number one. Select you. New foresight. Back sight. Yep, everything's gotta be fucking aligned. I think this last one will be good. Foresight. Back sight.
How's my Navy doing? They're doing fine. My Air Force is doing fine.
Back.
How's their battle of,
Yep, and that's fine. All these lower level odds. Yep.
We're not going to be able to take Leningrad. God damn it.
Memory points. Yeah, all's good. Okay. What else do I have to do? Sounds. I have to make the sounds work. We'll save again. Close you. Config CPP. I might just actually assault rifle. I'll take my AK-1 and just copy that instead. Select. Nope, don't. Select all. Copy. Scar. Select all. Paste. Alright. So now we find AK-47. Replace that with Scar. Place all. Six. Fucking basically new shit Frankenstein at this point.
Factory output. I need to save money to go to all adult serve.
Okay, 16.
We're running out of manpower.
Let's see, actually. CA. Weapons E. Data Anim Scar? No. These are some regular weapons. Data Anim Scar.
There's no way I can win that war.
So, we'll get rid of that. We'll try the MX then. This
war wasn't horrible. Leningrad. I can't move troops off of the Italian Sicilian coast. I can't move troops off the west wall, otherwise they'll D-Day me.
Gotta go fuck me what the scar was, actually.
Man, can you, like, sever Sino-German ties? Oh my god, can you please just go to war with the USSR? Oh my god. Please, Japan. There's actually no other way I can win. Like,
you suck.
No, I can do this. Like, I'm making a bulge towards Moscow now, and I've gained quite a bit of land since the Battle of Kursk. All the land gained is in the north towards Moscow, and I can't take out Leningrad in the north. I've had it surrounded for the past 6 months. Finland is obviously done for. Like, the Soviets they're just wasting troops up there at this point.
Yeah.
The south is right. Holding, but not well. Northern Ukraine is kind of breaking. I'm just waiting for the Soviet offensive to end, and then I'm going to run a counter-offensive. Because I'm winning most of my... if 90 or so percent of the defenses.
What the hell are you even... What side are you on right now? Like, what's your fucking nation at the moment?
I'm Germany right now. It is December 1943.
Are you fucking Nazi, bud?
Yeah, well, it's the historical...
You're on the historical route?
Gameplay mod. No. Like, it's a mod. It starts you off in 1943, right at the Battle of Kursk. And they try to simulate the time and how everything would have played out. Mm-hmm. So right now, all my troops on my front line are starving. I've managed to build up enough fuel for my tanks, but I don't have enough tanks anymore.
Fucking
rip. And I'm just... at this point, I'm just playing around with my production to see what I can do to get it up.
Enslave more Jews, I guess? Because you're a Nazi?
This guy gives me close air support ground attack. That only gives me armor max speed. Right. Yeah, we're going
to
do that.
So that'll be done in a few minutes, and I will be going back in game, probably to test it again. Alright. I'll do that retexture thing now.
I don't want to start my counteroffensive too early.
You're sitting fucking.
But now looks like a beautiful time to start, so I'm gonna start it now.
Okay, we will first hue saturation, just desaturate the whole fucking thing, so now it's a gray scar. We will then, quick and dirty. Shit. That's fine.
These guys are basically all starved to death, like. They're gonna like die out here soon, and then they're gonna break out of Leningrad, which I may actually let them do break out of it, and then encircle some of their troops when they break out. And
oh, that's good enough.
Make my life easier. How is the UK got encircled again down in Croatia?
All right, we're done, Keegan.
We're making huge gains in the north here. I'm going to try driving this guy around and down into Moscow. Okay, I got my manpower in finally. I'm probably going to need a second manpower buff, so...
good enough.
Oh, we just made it into Moscow.
Nice.
Take as much land surrounding Moscow as I can. Move my armor. Delete orders. Come to Moscow. And spearhead down this way. Alright, we took Moscow. It was a good hit. We basically have a giant penis sticking into the Soviet Union now.
Nice.
Seems good.
My fucking retexture skills are quite awesome. Fuck, I missed that piece. Whoops.
Move these tactical bombers over central Russia. That'll give me some bonuses there.
God, I'm fucking. All right. No, not posturize. Levels. Okay, we're done. Save you as a PN fucking G. Save. That done.
Holy shit!
What's up?
I have 500,000 deaths in the war against the Soviets. They have 6 million.
Sounds about right.
What the fuck? I guess building that 50 lines of trenches that I built when I was, right when I started the war, I guess that really helped.
I mean, they're fucking Soviets, so they can just keep throwing people at you, so you got a long way to go, bud.
Oh yeah, I know. I don't. It's not a huge bonus, but it is still, still a bonus there, bud. Now what do I want? What do I want to research? I guess I'll research a reconnaissance bonus.
All right, retexture of the scar is done in a very dog shit fashion. Let's take the weapons, steam armor 3, CM paste, and we're going in game to see what this looks like. Not that fucking black texture, but we'll see if everything's correct.
I almost control all of Ukraine now. I can actually move a couple from there to Central Russia. More tactical bombers to Central Russia. More tactical bombers to Central Russia. I can't put any fighters there because they didn't grab their airport yet.
Okay.
Move you guys over there. United States has joined the Allies. Now I can be scared. So I am now going to be at war with the U.S. And I'll have to figure out how I'm going to end that war. I don't even fucking...
What time is it? Oh, it's fucking... 11:20? Alright, I'm going to go out to eat lunch soon after I'm done doing this and upload that video. Which is still going, actually. I've just been fucking sitting waiting for like 20 minutes now. Whatever.
I can almost invite Spain to my faction, and that'll give me an extra zero troops. Wow, Spain is a fucking shithole. Alright, I don't even want Spain anymore, actually. Well, now I'm at war with the USA.
Are they gonna come over the Atlantic, or are they already there?
I assume so. I built a very large radar station. All of southern England, and I can see they have no troops there. And I do have the west wall up, and I do have a lot of naval bombers striking in the Bay of Biscay, so I might want to move them so they can't take them. So, yeah, I'm gonna do that.
We'll do what we want to, yeah. Okay. Let's get that. Let's get that loadout. Backwards? Oh, sick. Alright, so we're good. So now it bends when you have a scope. And it unbends when you don't have a scope. Floating with my hair, but that's fine. Whoops.
Just like I expected, the
Got the SVP. Some sculpts support as well. This one last night. This is mine. M110 fucking beast gun. AK, I did this one as well last night. 2 days ago. I gotta make suppressors for the AK as well. I gotta grab them like the PSO1. I gotta get good sound effects for some of these guns as well. Fucking use a Katiba for like 3 guns now. A lot of good stuff in the ARMA 2 stuff on my grab. Yeah.
He's so far into Russia and I just, like, I can't fucking move.
So, where's the fucker at?
Oh, they just retook Moscow. Fuck me. Oh, no.
All right. This one I did pretty well on. Ripped off the fucking iron sights from the CZ 805, I believe. That's it, boys. All right.